slide. This is awesome in your handout, but this is just, it brings it all together on one slide for you. Everything you kind of cover with the other slides, you can see it kind of starts from okay and it takes you all the way across.
And you have that kind of going from the possible exits from the fusion to what some of the thoughts or feelings, some of what might come next, some of the presenting issues we might see as clinicians, and then kind of therapeutic goals we might have to help them work through these issues. Any questions about, does this make sense? Does it jive with what you know to be true or anything up there that conflicts with?
We want to make sure we have time to do a couple pieces too.
Oh, I just have a quick question. I have a young lady that I've talked to, she's not ever expressed any, one of the questions I have is that she talks about, she seems to be sort of obsessed with the fact that she's not attracted to boys. And she's a freshman in high school, and so, you know, I mean, everybody develops a different
right.
But, right. You know, and so then she wonders if she's gay because she's not, attracted. And so I would say, well, are you attracted to girls? And she said, well, I think they're better looking than boys. And I said, well, I think they are too, but I'm not overall, but I'm not.
Yeah.
But I don't know. You know, I don't know.
And you know, you can't, what do we know about people coming in? Can we rush people? Can we hurry people in? We really can't. I think she's feeling the safe to talk to. And where would she fall here? Where, she's gone.
Yeah, she's gone.
So. Unsure, right? Mm-hmm. Kind of, she's not said, no, I can't be a lesbian, I can't be gay.
And I think because in her family she has some uncles who are gay. And so I know that's why.
She's okay with the idea of discussing it.
Yes.
Right. And so maybe she's going, you know, maybe she's looking through things and, I mean, she's unsure. She's unsure. And, you know, as much as you want to hurry people along, you know,
just keep the dialogue going
and touch back with her and just see if it goes anywhere. And she might give more hints. You know, I'm sure she's working on this in her head.
Must be.
Something's going on there. Maybe there'll be some deciding moment. You know, we need to have a deciding moment before we really want to claim or disown an identity.
And so they may test. Test the waters with you as an adult to see if
it's okay.
See your safe place.
Right. I mean, talking about sex with another adult that's not your parent is a big deal. It'd be a very big deal. I know. Huge deal.
This is just kind of another nice summary sheet. Looking at nice. Looking at some of the main risks about, you know, it's kind of putting together the different things you might want to have on hand, the idea about substance abuse counseling, information on resources in the community. We've got some things to hand out up here. Bring your handouts. I think I've included some resources in Indiana and then the National GAU Hotline. So you've got some things to put your hands on. The idea of support groups for feeling out of place, trying to find the right identity, and helping people know that, you know, there's not a single identity you have to own as a gay or lesbian, adult, teen, bi, transgender, whatever it may be. The desperation to meet others. You got a gay straight alliance in your school where you've got a great place where you can meet allies and gay, lesbian, bi, or trans students, and they're going to be peers. That's a marvelous thing to do. So if you don't have a GSA at your school, see what you can do to get one started. Really important to give them a safe place to meet similar teams. The idea of keeping to themselves and not get killed, not being able to be open, and I mean, help dealing with a new minority identity. I think that's hard if adults come out and suddenly, you know, if I've worked with women who came out as adults and had been married, and suddenly they can't do the things they used to be able to do. They can't enjoy, you know, that heterosexual privilege that everybody's given by right at birth. And until, if you live for a significant number of years with that and then lose it, it can be very traumatic. And adults can need support dealing with that loss of privilege. Counseling for anger management, fear, and isolation. Or just GLBTQ organizations that, you know, they can channel their anger by doing positive things for the community. If there are things that are available. And there's an Indianapolis called somewhere, but there's a youth group. Is that what it, what is it, Indiana Youth Group? Indiana Youth Group, right, which is a great place to get people involved where they can make a significant difference and feel like they're part of a bigger culture. So they're not just some isolated student or adult in Indiana. They're a part of something. And that sense we all want to be, we all want to believe.